Dear friends, welcome to this edition of VBS Anatoma, a series of e-learning videos in gross anatomy. Anatoma Jyotirgamya, meaning may anatomy lead us from ignorance to light, that's knowledge. The topic for today's gross anatomy is larynx, of which larynx 1 video is specifically on the thyroid cartilage. I have also called these as lockdown lectures or study at home videos because we are going through an extended period of lockdown due to the corona pandemic. I believe that these lectures will to some extent help you students to clear the backlog of portions. At least the theory part can be covered, and we hope to see you in the practicals as soon as possible. I am Dr. Balasubramanyam, professor in the Department of Anatomy, St. John's Medical College, Bangalore, in India. Let's start with a few MCQs, image-based MCQs. First MCQ. Here is a model of the larynx. Identify that particular structure pointed out by the red arrow. There are four options. One of them is the correct answer. Identify the correct answer. Next MCQ. Again, one more item. Same specimen model. What is that pointed structure? Third MCQ. We have changed the model. We have brought some other model of the larynx where it's not only the cartilages but also some muscles and certain neighboring structures like tongue and things like that are added on. Once again, one particular structure is shown, and identify that particular structure. MCQ number 4, a particular muscle has been asked for with an arrow. Identify that particular muscle. Last MCQ for today. The cartilage has been pointed out and its border has been asked. What is the border of this cartilage? The one shown by the arrow. All the answers are given at the end of the video. You can cross check. Let's go to the discussion. Now, this is a model of the larynx highlighting the cartilages. Shown in ivory yellow is the hyoid bone, but then we are focusing more on the cartilages. The large cartilage in the middle is the thyroid cartilage. Below that is the cricoid cartilage. I have used the word hyaline because that's the type of cartilage these are made of. Next, same view, one more cartilage is highlighted. That's the epiglottis. The type of cartilage here is different. It's an elastic cartilage. Next, same epiglottis and the cricoid are retained, but the view is different. This is a posterior view of the same model. You can see, in addition to the elastic, epiglottis and the cricoid cartilage, there is a pair of two new cartilages. They are the arytenoid cartilages. So far, we had seen thyroid cartilage, cricoid cartilage, and epiglottis unpaired. But now we are looking at a group of paired cartilages, of which what is highlighted here is the right and the left arytenoid cartilages. Largely hyaline, there may be occasional patches of elastic cartilage in this. Next, this is another specimen or the another model of the larynx, where in addition to the cartilages, certain other structures are, a lot of muscles are visible, nerves are visible, some mucous folds are visible, slightly a more detailed specimen. Note in particular, there is a fold running between the arytenoid cartilage and the upper end of the epiglottis. That fold is called the aryepiglottic fold. Very important. It's a mucosal fold, aryepiglottic fold. I have retained the label arytenoid cartilage for reference. Next, along that fold, there are two other cartilages, predominantly elastic in nature. One of them, the lower one pointed out, is called the corniculate cartilage. It's located at the upper edge of the arytenoid. And a little further down, further forwards, is the cuneiform cartilage along the aryepiglottic fold. In fact, the aryepiglottic fold is the lead fold in which these two cartilages can be identified. Let's examine, although we have identified the cartilages, let's focus today only on this thyroid cartilage. I made labeled it as the Roman shield. The way it looks like, it appears as if some kind of an armor or a protective shield. Next, the same thing. There are various parts of the thyroid cartilage. The largest part is the lamina, also a huge quadrangular part. That's virtually the body of the cartilage. Next, watch carefully now. It has an upper projection and a lower projection. The upper projection is called the superior corno. The lower projection is called inferior corno. Note that the inferior corno joins the cricoid cartilage to form a joint. That's the cricothyroid joint. I have highlighted it with this circular dashed circle, white blue dashed circle, which is being flashed. That is the joint, cricothyroid. There is slight mobility at this joint. Next, borders. The lamina that you saw, the main part of the thyroid cartilage, has an upper border and a lower border. Above the upper border is the hyoid bone. Below the lower border is the cricoid cartilage. Similarly, it also has an anterior border and a posterior border. Next, the upper border, when you trace medially, takes a dip into the anterior border. That dip is the superior thyroid notch. Because of the dip, the anterior border is complete only in the lower part, and that part is very prominent, particularly in the males, and it's called the Adam's apple. The angle at which the two laminae join is around 90 degrees and it's very prominent in the males. But technically the nomenclature is the laryngeal prominence or the thyroid prominence. It is less prominent in the females because the angle is around 120 degrees. Next, on the external surface of the thyroid lamina is the oblique line, roughly running from the junction between of the superior corno and the body and down towards the cricoid. Now that's the oblique line. It's meant for some muscle attachments, sternothyroid, thyrohyoid and thyropharyngeus. But then these names of these muscles at this point of the early discussion for a first timer is meaningless. We will try to catch up with these muscles as we go through the discussion in this video and the next few set of videos on the larynx. However, let's at least have a look at where these muscles are located. Next, This is, as I told you, a slightly more developed model than the previous, where only the cartilages were there. Attached along the upper border of the thyroid cartilage is the thyrohyoid membrane. It is attached from the thyroid cartilage to the hyoid bone. It runs from, I repeat, upper margin of the thyroid cartilage to upper margin, I repeat, upper margin, once again I repeat, upper margin of the hyoid bone. It goes behind the hyoid bone and then moves to the upper border. As a result, there will be a small bursa between the membrane and the hyoid bone. The central part of this thyrohyoid membrane, right in the middle sagittal plane, is thickened to form the median thyrohyoid ligament. A little posteriorly, as you trace the membrane posteriorly, you will see there are some vessels and nerves lying on it. It's very obvious. It's the superior laryngeal vessels and the internal laryngeal nerve. In the next slide, you will see these two actually perforating through the thyrohyoid membrane to gain access to the interior. Now you see, this is a posterior view of the cartilage model. Only the hyoid bone is extra seen. From the posterior view, the thyroid angle, that is the point where the two laminae are fused, I mentioned earlier, you know, it's 90 degrees in males, 120. At that angle has been highlighted in the dashed oval outline, white, red oval. Lot of ligaments and lot of muscles are attached. Once again, these have no meaning unless seen on a photograph. Let's look at these. There are vocal ligaments, vestibular ligaments, thyroepiglottic ligament. To some extent, we will try to identify these ligaments and the muscles. If possible, as and when we encounter, we will identify this in this video or maybe in the next video. Similarly, the muscles are vocalis, thyroarytenoid, and thyroepiglotticus. Now, this muscle that is shown on this side, see, notice that in this model, the thyroid lamina, that plate of cartilage, has been removed on one side. As a result, the thyroid, cricothyroid muscle, and other deep muscles come into view, of which only one, the cricothyroid, I have labeled. Now, the white membrane adjacent to it is the cricothyroid membrane. It is there, and the central part, just like in the thyrohyoid membrane, the central part is thickened to form the cricothyroid ligament. Now, whatever we have learnt about the thyroid cartilage, we need to, as I told you, it is not an isolated structure. It is amidst several other important structures. Now, we need to get an orientation. Right. Therefore, a specimen like this with everything shown may probably be an ideal one to catch up with the orientation details of the thyroid cartilage. That's why I called it as reorientation. That means we know a little late, but we need to understand how it is in its surroundings. You see, the hyoid bone can be identified. This is a posterolateral view of the larynx with the cartilage, with the muscles, with the ligaments, almost all the structures. You can see the tongue also superiorly. You can see the epiglottis. Now, the hyoid bone and the thyrohyoid membrane have been highlighted. I repeat, hyoid bone and the thyrohyoid membrane. Next, the tongue, it has been sliced in the midline, and the epiglottis also sectioned in the sagittal plane are also labeled. Next, I have retained the hyoid bone for the label. On the external surface of the thyroid plate or the lamina, along the oblique line, you can see the thyropharyngeus part of the inferior constrictor taking origin. There are other muscles like sternothyroid and thyroid, which are there a little in front on the same oblique line. The thyroid plate or the thyroid lamina posterior border is also seen. From this border, along this border, the superior and the inferior cornu are also noted. Next, among the muscles, once again, I'm just identifying these muscles. Details of orientation, origin, insertion, everything we will cover in due course. This is only to the extent that it forms an add-on information to the current thyroid cartilage lecture. So two muscles, thyroarytenoideus and the vocalis muscle, have been shown. That means this is a model where the mucosal fold has been removed on one side and the details have been highlighted. Next, below that, roughly below the level of the thyroid plate, but the lobe of the thyroid gland is located on the external surface of the thyroid plate. That's why I have highlighted the thyroid gland. That means the thyroid gland, the two lobes, right and the left lobe, are the upper part of these two lobes are plastered to the external surface of the thyroid lamina. Next, the muscle we have mentioned it earlier, but this is an important muscle located on the external surface, stretching from the oblique line up to the hyoid bone. To some extent, it covers the thyroid membrane anterolateral part. The cricothyroid muscle is located in the gap between the thyroid lower border and the cricoid upper border. The left lobe of the thyroid is also shown. Now you can see how the upper part of this left lobe is plastered to the external surface of the thyroid lamina. Now this is an important and a difficult view of the skeleton of the larynx. The thyroid cartilage can be identified, the epiglottis can be identified. The arytenoid cartilages are there, and extending between the arytenoid cartilage and the angle of the thyroid is the membrane called cricovocal membrane. This membrane runs from the upper margin of the cricoid cartilage to the vocal fold. Now, in fact, the upper edge of this cricovocal membrane is itself the vocal cord. See the two vocal cords, there's a small gap between the two. That's the vocal cord. Now this is, we are moving from skeletal, the cartilaginous skeleton model, to a model with the ligaments, membranes, and then another model with limb, with muscles, nerves, etc. We have finished all that. Now we are actually going to the real specimens, dissected specimen. Note the gentle blue appearance of the thyroid lamina and the cricoid, clearly indicating it's a hyaline design. The thyroid lamina is seen, the epiglottis is seen above it, and below is the cricoid. There is a muscle, below is the cricoid cartilage, a ring-shaped structure. There is a muscle there, I have not identified in this slide, but we will look at it in the next slide. Now that muscle, brown structure, is the cricothyroid muscle. We have identified the lamina of the thyroid previously. Now its upper projection, namely the superior cornu, is shown. Now when you see the anterior part, the thyroid notch and the subcutaneous thyroid prominence or the laryngeal prominence are also noted in this particular slide. Next, this is another dissection, the posterior view, where a few more muscles are there. But then let's identify among other things the lamina of the thyroid cartilage viewed from the inner aspect. Okay, viewed from the inner aspect, you can see the lamina of the cricoid cartilage. Now this is a posterior view, therefore the ring part of the cricoid may not be visible, but the lamina part is visibly a quadrangular piece, a flat zone located posteriorly, that is visible. It's the cricoid lamina. On the posterior aspect of the cricoid lamina are attached two muscles. There's the posterior cricoarytenoid, one of the most important muscles of the larynx. And if you look at it in terms of, you know, how important its function is, we could even say it's one of the most important muscles of the body. Although I will give you details in due course, remember, it's one muscle that causes, probably the only muscle that causes abduction of the vocal cords. Abduction of the vocal cords. All the other muscles are antagonistic to this muscle. Next. Again, one more dissected specimen. I repeat, one more dissected specimen. Front view. You can see some of the strap muscles are intact, at least on one side. That's the sternohyoid muscle. It doesn't attach to the thyroid at all, any of the thyroid components, but it goes superficial to it, so end to end. You can see the beautiful pearl blue color of the thyroid cartilage and the cricoid cartilage. You can also, I mean, not the cricoid, or the tracheal rings below. The cricoid cartilage is not seen here because the thyroid gland is covering it. Rather, the cricothyroid muscle is covering it. You can see below the cricothyroid, the left lobe of the thyroid gland is also very clearly seen. The right lobe is also there. The sternohyoid muscle is overlapping it. I think we have come almost to the end of the discussion. You can see the hyoid bone at the uppermost part of the specimen. Thyroid notch and the laryngeal prominence, and now shown as a label, the tracheal rings are identified. Now let's revisit the MCQs in the light of the current discussion that we have had. MCQ number one was the thyrohyoid membrane. Next, MCQ number two was the oblique line. It's located on the external aspect of the thyroid lamina. Next, MCQ number three was the superior cornu of the thyroid cartilage. It's difficult to identify this because other than the cartilage, there are a lot of membrane, ligament, muscles. Therefore, this is a tough one, but very, very important image-based slide for identification. Superior cornu. Next, the muscle is very easy. It has got its own signature shape and it is there between the lower border of the thyroid cartilage and the upper border of the cricoid cartilage. Therefore, this muscle is the cricothyroid muscle. Next, I told you this is a very difficult slide. The cartilaginous skeleton viewed from the back, skeleton of the larynx. The border is the upper border or the superior border of the thyroid cartilage. That was an overview of the cartilaginous skeleton of the larynx, of which we have discussed in detail the thyroid cartilage. I'm sure you will have some points to give me as feedback. You can write to me at this email address, or you can even post it on the blog area up below the YouTube video. Thank you, friends, for your patient listening. I hope this has helped you at an introductory level to get yourself oriented to the parts of the larynx. Remember, there are although it's a very tiny structure, the number of details that need to be identified is very many. That's the reason why, instead of running it as a long lecture, I have broken it down into smaller components, and I am handling each component in detail. I hope you have benefited from this lecture. We hope to see you soon in the practicals as early as possible, hoping that this pandemic will subside and the classes will open as soon as the government permits. Let's meet in the practicals. Thank you, friends.